Hello everyone, in this video we have one isosceles triangle and these two parts are equal and then here is a bisector line and these are 20 degrees and alpha is asked. Okay. First step, this triangle is given an isosceles triangle, right? Therefore, if it is 20 degrees, here must be 20 degrees because of isosceles triangle. And then if we draw a perpendicular line, this triangle is isosceles triangle. That means these two parts must be equal and this line must be symmetric line, right? Okay. If here is 40 degrees, this angle must be 40 degrees, and here apex must be 80 degrees, right? Therefore, 30 degrees left here. Let's remind you, if you have an isosceles triangle, if you draw a perpendicular, and if it is 40, this angle must be 50 degrees, right? So here must be 30 degrees. Okay. And then if we take the symmetry of this point like this, these two parts must be equal and let's call here P. P is the symmetry of the D point. Therefore, here must be 30 degrees and these two sides are equal, and then you know that these two parts must be equal because of symmetry. And notice that these are 60 degrees, that means we get an equilateral triangle. Right? Let's draw with green pen this side. And here, these are equal sides, right? Okay. And then 20 degrees left here, because here is 50 degrees, right? Because this line is a bisector line. And then notice that double line circle 20 degrees. Double line circle 20 degrees. That means if we connect A and P point like this, we get two congruent triangle. ACP triangle and BCD triangle are congruent. So we know that congruent triangles have same sides and angles. So here must be 20 degrees because it's opposite of the same length, right? If it is 20 degrees, this angle must be 20 degrees. Okay. And then ACP triangle is an isosceles triangle. That means this side must be equal to the others. Okay. If here is 20 degrees, we know that sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees. That means here must be 140 degrees. And then full angle equal 360 degrees. So here must be 160 degrees, right? Finally, notice that we get an isosceles triangle, right? Therefore, APD triangle, here is P point, APD triangle is also an isosceles triangle. Therefore, these are 10 degrees, right? As a result, we know that here is 40 degrees, so 20 plus 10 plus alpha equal 40 degrees. That means alpha equal 10 degrees. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate value of alpha using second method. Okay, first step, let's call these equal sides A unit, and these two sides, let's call B. And then here is 20 degrees also. And if it is 40, this angle must be 40 minus alpha. And apex is 100, that means here must be 80 degrees, right? Okay, so this angle must be 60 plus alpha. Okay, and then for this triangle, if we apply sine rule, B over sine 20 equal A over, here is 140, A over sine 140. Therefore, A over B equal sine 140 over sine 20. Okay, this is the first equation. And then for this triangle, if we apply sine rule one more time, B over sine 40 minus alpha equal A over sine 60 plus alpha. Therefore, A over B equal sine 60 plus alpha over sine 40 minus alpha. Okay, this is the second equation. And then, if we equalize these two equations, sine 140 over sine 20 equal sine 60 plus alpha over sine 40 minus alpha. So we know that we can calculate sine 40 instead of sine 140, and sine 20 equal sine 60 plus alpha over sine 40 minus alpha. And then we know that sine 40 equal 2 times sine 20 times cosine 20 over sine 20. So these are again 2 times cosine 20 equal cosine 20 over sine 30, right? Because we know that sine 30 equal 1 over 2. Okay. And then equal sine 60 plus alpha over sine 40 minus alpha. Therefore, we can calculate sine 70 instead of cosine 20 over sine 30 equals sine 60 plus alpha over sine 40 minus alpha. Now you can see easily 70 equals 60 plus alpha, so alpha equals 10 degrees. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.